Mr. Excel Podcast is sponsored by Easy Excel. Learning stuff from Mr. Excel Podcast, episode 1716, AutoFit, plus a little bit. All right, today's question sent in from YouTube from Mark. Mark is trying to do an AutoFit macro. Every time the worksheet changes, do cells.entireColumn.AutoFit, but he wants to add a little padding to make the cells a little bit more readable. All right, so Mark sent in this macro. Let's copy this, Control C, and we'll go back to Excel. We have our sheet here. This is sheet 1, so when I switch over to VBA, Alt F11, I want to double click on sheet 1 and paste that code there. It's not going in a regular code module. It is going in a the worksheet change event here right on the worksheet module. Now let's see how Mark's macro works. So I just change something on the sheet and it makes everything wide enough for the widest value in the column. But Mark is looking for a little bit of extra padding. So here's how we modify Mark's code. We're going to say for I is a variable, equals 1, 2, active sheet, dot used range, dot columns, dot count. All right, that way we're not going through and changing all 16,000 columns. We're just changing the columns that are actually in the used range. And we'll say columns dot I dot column width is equal to columns parentheses I dot column width plus, let's say 1. I don't know, maybe 0.5 would work better. You could experiment with that a little bit. And so now it does the AutoFit and it'll go through and change each column one at a time to be a little bit wider. Here, we'll try it again. I'll put in a 2. And yep, now are we actually seeing the columns shrink and get bigger? I figured we would, but it actually is going pretty fast. But just in case, let's do application.screenUpdating equals false. And then at the end, application.screenUpdating equals true. That should prevent us from seeing the flash. I'll type something in. And here, let's put in something really long. And it just automatically adjusts. I like that. That's a good little macro. Wow, it's quick. You'd have to add this code to each sheet that you wanted it to work on. Great idea from Mark, and a little bit of extra code there to add a bit of padding. Well, hey, I want to thank Mark for sending that question in, and I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another netcast from Mr. Excel.